Welcome to MCN and the Aprilia RS660. Now, we've ridden this bike at its world launch. We've done a lot of tests with it already with MCN, and we absolutely love it because this is the bike really that the sports bike world, normal riders, have been waiting for all these years. And the reason being is because it's the perfect sports bike for the road. So it doesn't make too much power. It's 99 bhp. In actual fact, we've had this on the dyno, and at the back wheel it makes 91 bhp, which for a 660cc parallel twin is a lot. That's kind of super twin racing engine power, and the kind of super twin that would blow up after a couple of laps. So it's quite powerful, but not over the top like a super bike or a super sport bike. It also handles very well. This bike is brought to you by the same people that bought the RSV4 to you, the Tuono, epic handling bikes. Brilliant, know how to make a bike go around the corner. So although the chassis parts aren't best of the best of the best, they're very, very good. And of course, there'll probably be a factory version with Olin's coming along soon. So it's fast, it's not too overawing, handles really well equipped. So you've got a color TFT dash with Bluetooth connectivity, you've got wings, you've got beautiful styling. It ticks loads and loads of boxes. It's not too expensive either, £10,100. It's a lot of bike for the money. But the thing that makes it really, really special for us is that it's comfortable. So this is a bike that doesn't contort you, the bike you can actually spend a little bit of time on, and it's easy to ride. And that's really what's been putting sports bike riders off over the last decade or so. They've just become too cramped. So Aprilia say that this bike sits beautifully between the two extremes of 600. So the super sport bike on the extreme side and the soft option, which would be something like a CBR650R. And as luck would have it, we've got two of these bikes here. So we're going to find out today if the Aprilia really is a middle ground between a super sport bike and a soft bike. So talking about the super sport bike, this is the F3675 MV Agusta. And in actual fact, it's the only super sport bike you can buy now, because for the road anyway, the R6 is now track only. The ZX6R isn't Euro 5, so they're not selling it. The GS6R and the Daytona have been discontinued. So, and the CBR isn't coming to the UK. So really, this is the only super sport bike you can buy in the UK anyway. This is slightly more powerful, 126 bhp, a lot more expensive, another £3,000 more. So you get lots of nice equipment, nice Brembos, electronics galore. On the cheaper side, you've got the Honda CBR 650R. Now, this makes 92 bhp, weighs a lot more, 207 kilos. That's 189 kilos. And that on the scales, full of fuel, is actually 181. So that's interesting. But similar bikes to this, you could say, would be the Ninja 650, which really hasn't got enough bite really compared to the Aprilia to be able to compare it like for like. And of course, another Italian twin, the Ducati Supersport. Now there's a new one coming along in 2021, which isn't available yet for us to test, but the older one really isn't sporty enough really to compete with the Aprilia. It's quite heavy, not that involving. And for an engine that powers exciting bikes like the Hypermotard, it's not that much fun. So really, these are the two bikes really that we're gonna compare the MV to. So we're gonna head out on the road, have a little ride on all the bikes, and we'll come back to you later on and give you our thoughts. I guess the first thing to say is the perception of 600s in general, that they're peaky and cramped and really single-minded, isn't really true when you've ridden these bikes on the road. Even the Supersport bike, which is a track bike, is still pretty good on the road. And it kind of makes a mockery of the fact everyone wants to go bigger capacity with super bikes and all the rest of it. So all three bikes are actually really, really good road bikes. The MV is an animal. The way it sounds, the way it bangs through its quick shifter and auto blipper, its sharp handling, its grip, its brakes is pure track, but you can enjoy it on the road as well. And what I'd say about MVs is that they've come a long way in the last few years since their new owners. They've really kind of tidied up the loose ends of their bikes. So it's still pretty single-minded in terms of how other super sport bikes can be, but the fueling is quite nice. It just rolls into corners really gently. The ride quality is pretty good. It's not that uncomfortable, but it kind of looks a little bit dated now, especially the dash, the old LCD dash makes it look a little bit old school. But it's very much the bike you'd buy if you've got a bit of cash, obviously, and the one you'd want to do track days on. And then at the other end of the scale, you've got the softer sports bike like the CBR. It's a couple of grand cheaper than the Aprilia. It's a lot cheaper than the MV, and you get a lot for your money. It's a comfortable bike. It's really, really well finished. It's four cylinders, so it's quite exciting when you rev it. It's very smooth. It's got a lot of mod cons on it. It's even got wings down by its belly pan, so it's got a little bit of MotoGP in it as well. But it's not the most exciting bike in the world, but it was never designed to be, really. But it's very comfortable, so it does a lot. You could go touring on it. You could probably do a track day on it as well, and it would be fine. So we wanted to know at the beginning of this video whether the Aprilia was kind of the middle ground between the soft sports bike and the super sport bike, and it really is. It really is two bikes in one. I mean, just from the riding position when you're just pottering around can feel like the soft sports bike. It's not too dissimilar to the Honda, actually. It's quite upright, very comfortable, not too much weight on your wrists. It's got a decent screen, decent wind protection. But when you want to play, it feels like a mini RSV4. It's even got the same kind of cutouts in the tank, the same kind of racy feel, the same kind of riding position, but it's all a little bit kind of toned down and more relaxed. So it's kind of two bikes in one in that respect. And the other big thing about it is the power. I mean, it's almost got 100 brake horsepower. On the road, all bikes go the same speed, whether it's a Fantic 500 or a Fireblade SP, you can only go so fast on the road. And the way the power's delivered on this is just perfect for road riding. It's got a lot of grunt when you want it. You can rev it and have a bit of fun when you want to. It's very, very smooth. Gearbox is really smooth. Sounds a lot better than you'd imagine for a parallel twin. It's quite a deep exhaust note, sort of rumbles, a bit like a Moto 3 bike at low revs, but then when you really, really rev it, it sounds like quite a harsh, strong V-twin. And then it handles beautifully as well. I mean, the suspension, obviously Olin suspension would ride better when there's a factory version, but you can't knock it at all. It rolls into corners beautifully, it's really stable. The ride quality is really nice. It runs on Pirelli Diablo Rosso Corsa 2 tyres, and they're quite plush. They're really, really grippy, as does the MV. And the Honda's got Dunlop Sportsmart TT. So actually, they've all got the similar kind of tyres, which are the level between sports tyres and track day tyres, which on a cold day like this, you probably don't want. You probably want something a little bit more road focused. And then the Aprilia is a lovely thing. I mean, its looks are a little bit divisive. Some people think that maybe it's not as bling as it could be. They think it looks a bit ordinary, but most people agree that it's as desirable as a superbike. It has got real presence. You know, the level of detailing, the beautiful top yoke, all these wings, the color schemes. It also comes in a great Loris Reggiani pastel kind of purple and blue colour as well, which looks fantastic. But this looks great as well. You probably can't see it in the video, but this red is really bright, almost like Marlboro red. For 10 grand, it's a lot of bike for the money. I mean, I'd have it over these two for sure. And as a road going sports bike, there's probably not much better. You might not want to take it to a track day. If you're an experienced rider and you went in the fast group, you probably get your hat nailed on by superbikes. But that's not what this bike is all about. You go and buy an RSV if you wanted that. In terms of giving you kind of real sports bike thrills, a bike you can live with every day, really the RS660 is a top bike.